Hi folks, welcome to the Lightroom blog channel. I'm Sean McCormick, and in this video we're going to take a look at metadata presets. Metadata presets are useful for adding information to all of the files in a batch. Things like copyright information can be included, as well as your contact details. You can have far more specific metadata presets for jobs. So if you're shooting a match, you could have the name of the home and away team, the stadium in which the match is taking place, even names of players and things like that could be prepared in advance so that you just apply them once the images are coming in. Now, these do have a little bit of an issue in that metadata presets are sticky. That means it remembers them on import. So you need to make sure that you have the correct one selected at the apply during import stage. Now, you can create your own preset at the apply during import stage, but I am going to do them from the metadata preset option in the metadata panel in library. So I'm going to come over here and I'm actually going to select an empty preset I've created just so that none of the fields have anything in them. Normally, if you're starting from scratch, there would be nothing in them anyway. But because I've previously had one created, it is remembering stuff. So to show you this from scratch, I'm going to start with an empty preset. So I click edit presets. And I'm going to bring up this empty one so everything's wiped. And I'm going to enter in copyright and creator information in this. So all of these red items must be now filled in. So for copyright, I go Option G. I'm going to put in the year because it's essential for the American system to have the year in the copyright. Putting in my name. Copyright status is going to be copyrighted. And this will put a copyright symbol in the title bar of the file name if you open it in Photoshop. For my rights, I'm going to have all rights reserved. You may want to use something like a Creative Commons rights usage where you can have commercial attribution and things like this, but that's up to you. The copyright info URL can be somewhere that's on your website. So I'm putting in my website address here. You may have a dedicated page for it, but in this case, I'm just sending it directly to my website. So now I'm going to add creator information. So that's obviously me. And I'm going to put in my studio address. So as you can see, all of this information is included so that people can contact you and get the information from you. Now, when we save this, we're going to save it with something that is definitely reusable. So save current as a new preset, and I'm going to call this copyright 2017. Just to mention that on PC, the copyright symbol is 0169. Alt, hold down the Alt key and type in 0169 and semicolon. If you can't get it to work, just copy and paste a copyright symbol from somewhere else to create. So that will then come up when I click done. It will now be an option here. And all that information will be applied to the selected file, or if you have a series of files, to all of the selected files. So if I select that here, it says mixed, so I'm going to go click here and apply it, so it's now applied to all of those. Like I say, if you wanted, if we click edit preset, if you wanted a dedicated preset, we could actually put in things like the caption in here, and even give things a ratings at the start. So if you wanted, for example, to have a 1-star rating on everything, and then when you put everything something to a 0, you can use a 0 as files to hide. So you could do that afterwards if you wanted to use that option. You can also include dedicated information here. If they were taken in one site, you could have a GPS location in here. So you could have one that's copyright 2017 in their studio. So it'll automatically have the information that is in the studio in it. You can also have video stuff that you put in yourself directly. And you can, of course, add keywords here to save you putting them into the keyword list afterwards. Now, generally, I will only use a copyright metadata preset because I want it to just apply that preset information. All of the other metadata I will add manually. So that's a look at editing and creating metadata presets.
Hey, folks, I hope you enjoyed that and that you got some benefit from it. Metadata presets are useful for getting your copyright information out with all your files, so I do recommend using one, especially on import. Now, if you like the video, do hit the thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed and you want to see more content, please do subscribe. And the other thing, of course, is if you want to get an email letting you know when I've got new content, do hit the notification bell. It's great for getting notification of all of the channels that have new stuff up and that you're interested in, and I do recommend it. And so folks, really, thank you for taking the time to watch this. I really do appreciate it. If you want to leave comments, leave comments. All right, thanks again.